Hey everyone, I will show you how you can build the bell-driven mod for your Ender 3. So with this modification you can solve problems like bent or not properly aligned lead screw, Z-wobble, a hanging X-axis on the right side, or things like that. This modification has helped me and many others to improve the print quality, but I want to make clear that I'm not an expert and 3D printing is just my hobby. The modification is not that difficult and takes about an hour. If you have any questions, feel free to post a comment. And if the speed on is too fast for you, you can find a link to the original recording in normal speed in the video description. All my parts are printed in PETG. Changes to the firmware are not necessary. There's also a version for bone setups and one for linear rails. There's also a written tutorial with pictures on Thingiverse. There you can find a list with all the parts you need as well. All files can be found on Thingiverse. For licensing reasons, the warrant parts are stored on GitHub, but everything is linked in the menu. Before we start, I want to thank everybody who supported this project and gave some special thanks to Creality for the Global DRY contest. I don't know how to say that, but I'm just speechless because I was able to get to the third place. So I just want to say thank you for your support, for your votes, for your help, but now let's start with the build. Before you can start with the build, the original Z-axis and the power supply must be removed. You will need the Z-motor in the first step. We will start with the assembly of the transmission. For this, you will need the parts as shown. For the 20 teeth pulley with the 8mm bore, you have to remove the flange. Now, insert the 20 teeth pulley into the printed pulley and fix it with 5 screws. Remember to put in 2 nuts before you screw the tensioner arm to the motor. The 16 teeth pulley doesn't need to be aligned so precisely now, we will take care of that later. Please use washers when you bolt the motor to the transition body. We will also align all of this later. The 4 608 bearings are just pressed into the holes. Please be careful to not break the parts when your holes are too tight. Now move on to the plates. This step is very important. If you forget the nuts, you will have to take everything apart later. So check twice if you inserted the nuts. For the lower parts, we need the small bearings. You need 2 per side, insert them like this. Now all preparations are done and you can start with the main modification of the printer. It's not important where you place the transmission, it also can be mounted on the side, but I like the middle the most. Next, you need to remove the screws at the top of the frame. It's the best to do it side by side and not both sides at the same time, so it's easier to keep the frame square. You can reuse the original screws for the normal version, but for the rotated transmission, they are too short. And make sure to check in between if your frame is still square. Do this for both sides. Thank you. Now you have to mount the new plates. Remove all the wheels and the outer M5 screw. To replace the inner M5 screw, you have to remove the right M4 screw, loosen the left one, so that you can turn the plate a little. Replace the original screw with a 40mm M5 one. Make sure that the head fits under the profile. Now you can fix the plate to the profile again. Make sure to assemble the wheels in the correct way, so original spacer, wheel and printed spacer. I use an original spacer here as well, because I have some left from my linear ray build on my other end. Make sure the inner bolt has the accented nuts installed the right way and fits snugly in the plate. The two small holes on the inside of the printed plate are for converting to linear rails, so you can change the rails at any time and only have to print two small adapters. Add some nuts to the screws and you are done with the right side. Before you can start with the left side, you need to rotate the X motor so that the connector is facing out. Then you just need to loosen the nuts and replace the metal plate with a printed one. If you are using a bowden extruder, take the plate with a motor mount. I uploaded a version with motor mounts for both sides. Finally, you have to mount the bottom parts. Make sure the orientation is correct so that the open back is facing up. As you can see, you can also use the original lead screw. You don't have to use a hardened steel rod like I do, a cheap aluminium rod is fine too. Now slide the last two pulleys and the printed pulley on the rod. Don't forget the small loop belt and align the rod so that it sits on both sides in the outer bearings. Now you need to adjust the 16 teeth pulley. Align it so that the small loop belt can pass over it straight and without any problems. My distance doesn't have to be the same as yours. Tension the small loop belt with the printed wheel. Then secure the motor with the two small screws. Now let's start with the fun part. We have to install the belts. First, you have to cut them. It's very important that both belts have the same length. I like to put the two belts together like this and use the teeth to align both sides. Secure the belts with the lower clamp on both sides. As I said, it's very important that both sides are clamped in the same way. Place the tensioner block completely on the belt, so it's sticking out at the other side. Do this the same way for both sides. Insert the block into the housing and be sure to tension both sides equally. It's the best to count the number of turns the screw you have made, then you can be sure that both sides are equal. Now move the X-axis all the way up so the wheels touch the printed parts. Tighten the two grab screws on both pulleys, this way you can make sure that the X-axis is parallel to the frame. Make sure that the belt is centered and do not run over the top printed parts. The last step is to connect the motor. If you bought a new cable, be sure that the middle two cables are crossed. The cables usually arrive with the wrong orientation, but I will show you how you can make the cables right. With a pair of tweezers, you can press down the small holes on the connectors and pull them out. Orient the connectors so that they are crossed in the middle, but the outer ones are the same as at the motor side. Just connect the cable to the mainboard and the build is done. Congratulations, thanks for watching and have fun with the modification. If you have any questions, feel free to write a comment under this video on Thingiverse or GitHub, or write me a message via Discord. And as always, happy printing!